Hi guys, it's Alice, and today I'm going to show you all of the lovely books I got in November. And as usual, there's quite a lot of them, so we're just gonna get straight into it. First up, you know me, I can't really pass a really good cover by, and I also really like poetry, and I like collecting books like these, so I had to pick up A Poem for Every Winter Day, and this is edited by Ali Asiri. You may have seen me mention the book A Poem for Every Autumn Day, and I feel like I mentioned that in every other video ever since I got that book because I just thought it was so beautiful. Like, the design of these books are amazing. And I did actually read that book and I really enjoyed it. I feel like these types of poetry collections are always like a mixed bag because there are loads of different authors and styles and themes, and that's just the way it is with these types of books. But I really enjoy them anyway, and they're making one for every season, and I'm just gonna have to get them all. It's gonna happen because this cover, like these covers, it's my favorite thing. The second book I got, and actually a bunch of books that I picked up this month, were inspired by the fact that I was reminded of how much I love adventure stories. I rewatched The Mummy and it just reminded me how much I love stories like that. So I picked up a bunch of books that were sort of inspired by it, and the first one is Seven Deadly Wonders by Matthew Riley. I've never really heard anyone talk about this book, like I've never seen it before, but I went down a little bit of a adventure book rabbit hole on Reddit, and someone mentioned this book, and I was just like, sure, I want to give it a go. It's sort of like an adventure mystery thriller, and it's about this legend, like an ancient legend, that says that every 5,000 years or something, a solar event will wreak destruction on the Earth unless someone does something that involves like the pyramids of Giza or something. I really don't know, I just thought it sounded like fun. On the same Reddit page, I also found a recommendation for the book Sandstorm by James Rollins. This is also an adventure thrillery type of book, but I think it has a little bit of science fiction in it, and it's about this lost buried city in the Arabian desert or something, and then about these people who go to check it out, I think. I'm pretty sure the main characters are women, which is always great, and I was sold at the like lost buried city in the desert because that sounds amazing. Next, I picked up Crocodile on the Sandbank by Elizabeth Peters. Guess what? It's another adventure book, although I think this leans more towards like historical fiction mystery, and the story is about this woman who goes on her first trip to Egypt and has some sort of adventure involving like archaeology and mummies. That's all I really know, and that's all I really need to know. Then, moving on to something a little bit different, I got Misery by Stephen King. I really haven't read a lot of Stephen King's books, and every once in a while I will like look into his books to try and figure out what I want to read, but then he has written so much that it's just a little bit overwhelming. But apparently this is one of his best books and most famous books, and I have actually never seen the movie for this, which I know a lot of people love, so I don't know the story of this at all. All I really know is that it's about an author who I think is kidnapped by his biggest fan or something, and that sounds very intriguing. We've then got some books in Norwegian, so I picked up Sirkelens Ende by Tom Egeland. This has been translated into English and it's gotten the English title Relic, and this is the first book in like a mystery thriller type series that's kind of in the same vein as The Da Vinci Code and books like that, which I actually generally really enjoy. They're never like my favorite books of all time, I just find those types of stories so incredibly entertaining. So I thought I would give this a go. It starts off with someone discovering a relic and some sort of manuscript, and the main character is determined to find out like where all of this comes from and what it means. I also got Formørkelsen by Karin Fossum. This hasn't been translated into English as far as I'm aware of. I think it may have been translated into some other languages though, I don't really know. A friend actually gave this to me because she just thought I might like it, and all I know is that it's about a child who dies and the mystery surrounding that death. Then we're moving on to nonfiction books. And the first book I have was sent to me by a Norwegian publisher, and it is På Åstedet by Eva Berabde and Trude Teige. This title translates to At the Crime Scene, and this book is all about criminal investigation and like forensics, I think. And one of the authors is one of Norway's most distinguished forensic technicians, and she has worked on a lot of different cases, a lot of really big ones like the 2011 terror attack here in Norway. And the book is about the cases that she's worked on and the work that she does, which I think sounds fascinating. I think some of it, like especially the terror attack stuff, is gonna be so difficult to read about, but I'm also really interested in this topic, and it'll be interesting to read a book about this that focuses on Norway, because I wonder if we do things differently here and like what we do. I think it's gonna be fascinating. Second of the nonfiction, I had to get Troy by Stephen Fry. This is the third book in Stephen Fry's Mythology Retellings series, and I am so excited about this book. This is one of my most anticipated releases of the whole year because I loved both mythos and heroes, and this one obviously explores Troy, which I really don't know a whole lot about, and I can't wait to learn about it in Fry's funny but educational style. Lastly, I got four books that were very much inspired by the fact that I got back into adventure books, and I really like reading about history and archaeology, and it's been nonfiction November, so it's just been like the perfect storm for me to get more books. And the first one is Jungle of Stone by William Carlson. This is a biography about two guys who in 1839 went into the jungle of Central America and discovered some ruins in there that completely changed the West's idea of human history. And it takes a look at the remarkable story of the ancient Mayans. I also got Lands of Lost Borders by Kate Harris. This is a travel memoir about a woman who always wanted to become an explorer. And this book is about her biking the entire Silk Road from beginning to end. And I just thought this sounded interesting because I like memoirs, I like travel narratives, and I like stuff about the Silk Road. Second to last, I got The Curse of Oak Island by Randall Sullivan. This is a history book all about Oak Island and its legend of having buried treasure. And it offers up a comprehensive history from its discovery to present day. And we get to meet all kinds of different people who have become involved with this island and trying to find what may be buried there. Lastly, I got Three Stones Make a Wall by Eric H. Klein. This is a history book all about archaeology and how it evolved from being a sort of amateur pursuit to becoming what it is today. And I think we get to read about like the science stuff that they use in archaeology nowadays. And because I'm a nerd, I'm very excited to read all about it. Okay guys, those are all the books that I had to show you today, and I would of course love to know if you've read any of these and what you thought, or if you want to read any of them. Links to my other social media and my Patreon will be in the description if you're interested, and I'll see you soon. Bye!